Per coding. So, hello friends. Today I'll teach the very special subject in great network marketing industry. This subject is duplication. Easy steps that will lead you to success in networking business. My name is Kęstutis Gudynas. Some friends from abroad call me in a shortened way, Kes. I'm expert in blockchain and cryptocurrencies industry, sales and multi-level marketing trainer and practitioner. And the reason I'm giving this training is because I have been in this industry for around 4 years and succeeded to get among top 100 earners in a company with over 500,000 partners. So I have accumulated some experience that might be useful to you, and I will share it in my duplication training. Okay, so depth versus width, or why do people fail in network marketing? So when building structure in network marketing, it is important to understand your goal, what I want to achieve. If I want to get a long-term stable business, I must focus on finding people, my team members, who are committed as I am and are loyal and willing to succeed. The first step is to find few people for my first line and work with them. So we could say maximum 5-10 new people at the same time. Then we go to train them, help them to find other people and introduce them to this system. Registering a person does not automatically double your efforts. If the sponsor leaves, the people they support will also leave, as those people won't be able to work on their own. So you must depend into at least three levels, and you must teach your clients to master the skills of duplication and build, as I said, at least three levels deep in your structure. Then you can let these people work on their own, for them to do what you already did, building their structures already with their people. It is the law of duplication: to do it yourself, to teach the other person, to train this person how to teach and train the other partner in his or her depth. Then you can continue to register new people in your first line and duplicate all once again. Right, so the goal is to teach your peers and they will teach their peers, okay? Or we call you teach your partners and your partners will teach their partners. How to build and implement the system. At the beginning, it's important to create a system of communication and system of your network's work so that new people can participate in trainings, seminars, public presentations, webinars, meetings, conferences. It is difficult to duplicate the work style of any of us, as we are all different. Everyone is a personality with a specific approach, with different skills. One person would prefer one working style, and other would prefer some different style. So what is possible to duplicate very effectively is the system itself. Clients should be taught how to behave, what action to perform in this system in order to make their business work and be successful. Our clients should learn how to invite their potential clients to meetings, webinars, public presentations. So 10-15 minutes before the start of the webinar, you should call the invited guests and make sure that they have no problems with entering the webinar room. After the end of the webinar, the client should be called again and asked if they need more information. And you should immediately arrange and appoint the next day or to register client right away. Seven sponsors tasks. And you know, we call sponsor, so we call the person who called you to business, we call them sponsors, okay? So seven tasks for sponsors, for the person who registered others to this type of business. If I'm registering new clients for business, I must take responsibility for their career development and explain what I will teach them. Each sponsor must understand seven important things that lead to success. So first thing is setting goals. Second is making a list of names. Third is a right time planning. Fourth is invitation to a meeting. Then presentation, follow up, and handling the objections. So let's take a closer look to the individual tasks of the sponsor. Right, let's come back to setting goals. Each goal built with a new client must be so-called SMART, okay? We use those letters of the word SMART. S stands for specific, concrete. M is measurable goal that has measurable parameters for it to be evaluated. A is actual, achievable. Set such goals that are realistically achievable for you, not abstract ones. You know, they must be like the ones you would be able to believe you can do it, okay? So not some you would think they are too far, too difficult to reach, because achievable goals motivate you to succeed. Okay, R is real, necessary, and consistent with our mission. And T stands for it should be time limited. Okay, it should be well timed, and we must understand in what time frame we speak. Right. Setting smaller targets. So in life, you need to know what you want to achieve, where you are going to. Look at your life over the past 10 years. Where were you 10 years ago? Okay, where are you now? What has changed in your life over the past 10 years? What would you like to change in the next 10 years? write your goals in accordance with the principle. You start from the long-term goal, so you put the goal for 10 years or more, then you go backwards. You write down the goal for 5 years, 1 year, 6 months, 1 month, and later you start weekly schedule and filling daily actions list. Right, so short and long-term goals. Write down your goals in the overview chat and tell your family and friends about them. When you publish your goals and your friends know about your goals, so they become mandatory and you will try to achieve them. After all, you do not want your family and friends to laugh and blame you for not achieving something you promised to yourself. Objectives, first and second month with your sponsor. So if you want to realize your dreams, you must change terms for them to become your goals. First months of cooperation, learn, train, learn to work with your personal office, perform those tasks that will later become clients' tasks. So that's what we spoke about, 7 sponsors' tasks. Actively cooperate with your sponsor. Okay, this relationship must help you. So this is very important. You cooperate with your sponsor and you are proactive in trying to reach your sponsor on a daily basis. Okay, plan 10 direct sales to achieve and achieve a first status, okay, first leader status within 2 first weeks according to the marketing plan. Then your promotion goes to next status, selected for 3 best peers or 3 best partners, and help those partners to reach their first rank. So your career goes as you make your partners successful. Teach them what your sponsor has taught you. Make a plan with them for their achieving next status and help them to do it. Building a structured network is the basis for constant additional income in the future of those who create business in network marketing. So for your network to develop successfully, you should add new peers, new partners, train them to know the system of duplication so that they can do exactly the same things that you do. In this way, you ensure that your structure grows in depth and in width. List of contacts. The list of contacts is the most valuable asset you have, but many networkers underestimate this phenomenon. Contacts shouldn't just stay on your mobile phone. You should write them down on paper and actively work with them. Adding notes to your contacts, regularly expanding your list, updating and evaluating your partners. So for example, when I meet new client for the first time, I ask them their contacts and give them mine. Relationships are part of our life, and not using them is just harming yourself. The book of contacts is your capital, so you must look at it with a good focus. Don't select clients, don't decide for them, don't predict or guess. Business card. An important part of new contacts are business cards, which you can get from your acquaintances, friends, as well as from known people at various meetings, conferences, business meetings. And you need have professional business cards for exchange, so that the person who gives you his business card could contact you as well. Business cards, other than tangible items like pens, magnets, pins with your name and the name of your company, which are recognized tools among business professionals. So they are the great way to make lasting impression on people you meet. Okay, something you hand over to people, it stays with them for a long time. So you must think what things with the official promotional material, information you use, and what you share from your side. Your success begins with the creation of your contact list. So when having written down the names in your list, divide them into two groups. One group includes potential team members or partners who can be contacted for co-working, and the other group is a potential investors. So gradually contact the people from your list, arrange meetings, and explain the benefits of investing into our project, and explain benefits of working with our company. How to get more contacts? Following trainings, and we'll give you more knowledge and some specific strategies. Okay, how you can grow your contact list once you run out of your personal list. But remember, your personal list, if you put everyone on it, it should be quite long. It should be something like 300, 500 person. And let me give you one more insight and stop here for a short while. Okay, so how do you think about contact list you create? You open your contact list and you see different part of person, okay, different people. You evaluate those people in different way. So unless you are ready and committed to go all the way through all of your list of those 300 and 500 person, so you can work with all of them. But my insight to you is this: if you doubt yourself even a little bit that you will be able to work all the list long, so choose the top 60 contacts out of your list. Okay, this will help you a lot, because you do not want to grow your family with people who are of the lowest quality. Okay, when you choose people out of your list, you must think not of the most rich, not of the most influential or something, but think of the most positive and the most enthusiastic people. Okay, so I leave you with this special insight about building your list on this training. Okay, and on every training, we will give some extra insights. Right, best start. Many novice network marketing partners make one serious mistake, trying to get rich quickly. They choose successful people with higher status, like entrepreneurs, directors, politicians from the contact list, and think they will admire our offer and make very big investments. So usually it turns out quite the opposite. More often than not, they won't even hear you out promising that you will definitely be contacted, that this is very cool, but you won't hear from those people never again. Where did the mistake happen? They see that you are new in this business, you are not confident, you can't answer the question, you talk a lot and won't listen. You try to persuade, you push them hard, and then there's disappointment when they don't invest and you say that the business doesn't work at all. So those people, they might have some similar experience out of other people coming to this business, and you must understand that they might behave quite different than you expect. So one of strategies is to train on relatives. Start learning to make presentations in your family for your friends and acquaintances. Gain skills, learn how to answer questions, learn about company's history, technical details, and gain confidence in the project in yourself. Only then you can go for important people. Okay, and let me reverse the strategy. Okay, because this training gives the strategy of starting from the closest circle, and this strategy, if you listened well, it gave you the reasoning before. You have to be trained to go to best people in your contact list. So if we take another strategy I shared with you, top 60 contact strategy, what you would have to do, you would have to do training, duplication training, and simulation of calls and simulation of meetings training prior you go to those people. So before you go to them, you train yourself. Okay, this is very important. So it's kind of a reverse strategy, giving you a chance to go to a lower quantity of people, but it does not mean you go to get your training on your top contacts. Okay? So this was important, and I thought I will expand this subject on this training for you a little bit, because it might help you to have a good, fast start in this business. Time planning. Okay, planning your time is one of the most important activities in network marketing, but usually people underestimate it, and usually if they ever do it, they do it chaotically. So the result of such an activity is that they don't have time for anything, and they don't end up doing those things that they have to do. Plan your activities for every day. Make up to 4-week basis activities plan, so you know exactly when you are going to dedicate yourself to your family, to your hobbies, to your work with your sponsor, you'll have an overview of your planned meetings, trainings, and studies. Make your weekly plans with your sponsor and let your family know about the plan. So family members know when you hold some events together. In this regard, duplication is a very serious matter. You shouldn't do that on a weekly basis until planning becomes a habit. And I recommend that you make plans for next week every Friday afternoon. Evaluate your weekly plans regularly and keep statistics on what you have done in a week. A special and one main parts of your business plan should be the exact planning of support for your structure and the process of tracking new clients. So, of course, as we said, the activity, the planning starts from planning your work with your sponsor. The more time you can arrange with your sponsor, the bigger success is waiting for you. Okay, let's say it this way. Right, work systematically. Plan your time. It's the most valuable resource you have, and it's always scarce. Treat your time seriously and spend it consciously. Arrange personal presentations. Register new people and invite them to webinars, trainings, and presentations. Involve them in network marketing training. Train them according to the duplication system. That is the only way to help you and to help your people who are coming for duplication. Work with people, meet regularly with them, okay, and with your business partners or structures, as we call them. The result of your systematic work will be that you will help your team members to succeed. You will become successful yourself and reach high career levels. And once and for all, you will solve all the money issues, okay? Many people think about this like of the first and the most, the biggest issue why they do network marketing. So once you solve your money issues, the whole new life will start for you. Right, we go to invitation and phone call. During phone conversation with potential clients, in order to invite them to a personal meetings or the first online webinars, it's important to master three skills. First, being able to build a rapport with the client during a phone conversation. It is very important to attract the attention of the person from the very beginning. When he lifts the phone, and keep his attention for the next minimum 5, 20, 30 seconds. Okay, so your start of your phone call would be very strong. Second, being able to effectively ask questions when communicating with client and create an atmosphere of importance and urgency in this meeting. Next, being able to listen. Don't forget to listen to the client and talk less without interrupting or putting pressure on the client. We use positive language. If we want to achieve the desired and expect the results, you should always be positive yourself. Pronounce the words properly. If we want to achieve your goals in your phone call, you should pronounce words clearly, properly, and in a personal meeting, you also lead a conversation providing the power of arguments. So you should talk clearly, expressing your thoughts, pronounce it very well, okay? Be the one to be easy to understand. Right, let's talk about phone etiquette. Create a script. A brief description of the phone conversation or short scenario, which is your guide for the interview. But do not read it, okay? When you read while talking on phone, your script is short, you must learn it by heart. You must know it. It's better to improvise than to read, because reading gives different emotion. So this is important. The short script call that you have, it will help you during the conversation, so you wouldn't get stuck looking for some words, or you want to get some questions, you want to give some questions to your clients, so your script will help you to follow it. Try to speak slowly and clearly. You may be a little bit nervous, which is natural, okay, but this is perfectly normal. The nervousness will go away after few calls. You need practice. Once again, do not read, okay, the prepared script. It has to be fluent out of you. And what we usually offer people, if you want not to risk losing your clients just before you get ready, okay, and first 3, 5, 7, 10 calls might be a little bit awkward. So best thing is to get to a separate simulation and do those phone calls as a simulation to a people in a training group. This is one more insight you can take into your teams. Okay, this is very, very important. Don't let your people go and practice on their top contacts. Let them practice in closed groups. Set this closed training for your people. And okay, once they are ready, they can go and do the effective phone calls. Be prepared for your clients saying no or thank you, I'm not interested. Just think, so what? It will call another, okay? You will make another phone call, you will call another person. And honestly, they may answer even much more rude. But don't just get upset because of it, okay? Not everyone will understand the opportunities of our business. And it's okay. You can just say goodbye to the person and thank him or her for taking time to listen to you. At the end, you can say, yes, Mr. Mrs., you are probably right. This business is not for everyone. To get good results, phone call schedule be practiced with a great perseverance. If you have email address of the person with whom you talked, so you can send him thank you letter, and you can add some motivational extra video or link to a good article about the technology. So remember, practice makes it perfect. It will take some time to gain confidence, but as soon as you will find that you start enjoying the conversation with the potential clients, it will start rolling in the place you want it to go. And remember, the worst thing that can happen during your phone call, someone will tell you no. So what? Okay, so what? Someone else is waiting for your phone call. Phone call is just the very start. You start the conversation, keep it going, okay? And how you start? You pronounce name clearly. Ask for an opinion. You can put some compliment at the very start. Listen to what people talk to you. And one more thing that will help you in this conversation, you smile yourself, and positivity will bring more positivity out of the person you speak with. Okay, so I will give you some more insights for this subject probably next time. Okay. And now if the answer is no, okay? Remember, this is not the end of conversation. Just put yourself in other person's shoes. The client is not interested in your success. They are interested in their own well-being. So, okay, see, thank you anyway. Right, create a comfortable atmosphere during a conversation. As we say, one tempo, one terminology, and one style. Okay. Listen all the way and do not interrupt other person talking. People do not care of what you know before they know how much you care about them. So once you show yourself as a good listener, people understand you care about them. Not all calls are answered with yes. And this is also good. Life would not be interesting if all we're doing what we do. So remember, we need teachers, we need doctors, artists, people who choose to do something else and who choose to think in different way than we do. So this is okay. We understand someone is waiting for this opportunity you are bringing, but we don't expect every single one to do what we expect. Use open questions. The task of open question is to keep the dialogue going, and you ask a potential client a question that begins with something like, what do you think about it? How do you like something? What is your opinion about something? During client's answers, you can think, listen, and prepare your next question, prepare your next things you will say. Use probing questions. These questions will allow you to ask the client for a more detailed answer to your question, which will make it clear that the original answer was correct, but not quite sufficient or not quite accurate. The purpose of such question is to help the person think more deeply about the subject matters of the conversation. Right, one more type. Questions that close the conversation. These questions allow you to confirm that you have understood the client and that the client has understood you. These questions actually confirm this situation which you have agreed on with the potential client. Pre-closing questions. Do you understand everything what I was talking about? Okay, this is pre-closing question. I would like to hear this confirmation from you for me to know you understand everything correctly. The key point is listening carefully to the client, to what they are saying. The key to an effective way to ask questions is simply to listen to the person you are talking to. You will have time to formulate your next question and you can get important information about the client. Speak with the enthusiasm and optimism, and your voice should sound vibrant. Do not be negative. Make template scenarios, but do not read out of paper. You know, we usually say for the conversations, if you do conversation on a phone, it's always better when you doing it by when you stand and talk to people while standing. This gives you a different breath and this gives you a different temper of your voice. This shows more energy, more enthusiasm to person, and person on other side feels it. So even small details that we prepare people in prior trainings before they go to actual work, they are very, very effective, okay? And it's good for people to have such a group trainings before you send them to, as we call, to the real field of work. Business meeting presentation. What is most important in the first few minutes of business meeting? Remember, do not talk about yourself. Do not talk about your products. Do not talk about your services. Take care in how you are dressed. You offer exceptional business. You cannot be wearing shorts even if it is very hot, maybe 40 degrees outside. How you are dressed will influence what package your client will buy. So show confidence, show that you are a professional from here and that you respect client, and do not judge client yourself. Even if at a first glance you might think he has no even 10 euros for investment, okay? Do not judge. Sometimes this first impression, thinking about clients, are very, very wrong. find out what kind of world the client lives in and try to find out what are the dreams. This will help you because your solutions, the solutions you bring, they might be dreams orientated. Okay, so this is very right. Look at the slide and tell which speaker will be more trusted. Okay, this is talking about the business look. Seven steps for a successful sale. So first, show your client that investing in the project is wise and meaningful. Tell your client about reliability. How can the client invest safely? Ask your client about their needs. Find out what they really want. Summarize several benefits of the packages and also describe your vision of the project. Questions: are you interested? Which option is best for you? Installments or lump sum direct investment? And ask questions that close the phone conversation or business conversation. Find out the client's financial possibilities. Explain to them the importance of the next stage of the project and the company development stage. Describe the registration step and register new partner. So that's the seven steps. Okay, let's look at commercial meeting and sales interview. So principles of the business meeting are the following. It should be brief, clear, with a short summary at the end of presentation. The structure of the business meeting: introduction, okay, so initial contact, find out what is the client needs. So this is questioning and a good listening to client. Then you offer the solution. Then you might have to turn into argumentation stage, handling the objections, and of course keep focus on client needs. And the technique of closed questions will help you. Okay, questions, the type of questions we already spoke about, and you go to client's registration. So closing the deal, yeah, registration and closing the deal, choosing the package, and of course you go and talk about business side at the end of closed deal. Now closing techniques. Each sales interview leads to your client's decision making. Do not be afraid to offer the client registration and ask them what kind of investment they are interested in. Recommend the best investment from you, the best investment for them. And if you have already received the information, okay, by dialogue, so you would know what might be the needs of your clients. And my suggestion would always be to go from the very top packages or from the top one, and you lower down only when you are for 100% sure the top package is not at the level of your client's needs. Right. Alternative questions suggest two options where the most likely answer is yes. Shall we agree on installment or on a lump sum investment? Shall we undergo the registration first, or shall I help you to conclude a cooperation agreement? Okay, so you can give those alternative questions. Both of you are good for you. And there is another strategy of questions that lead to answering yes, and questions with yeses, like, as I remember, you enjoyed the opportunity, didn't you? Yes. Do you agree with me about something? Yes. Is something better for you? Yes. Okay, you form in the way you now you know the answer should come yes. Have you made sure in the advantages of our project? Yes. So you will be able to invest, and I will help you to undergo registration. Is that correct? And you wait the last yes. So technique of yes is also one of the strong techniques that can be used for closing the deals. Right, let's talk about Benjamin Franklin's technique. Okay, so this method, what do we see? It should help people to make a decision. Usually it's used at the end of conversation when you see you cannot handle or close the deal. So you can take this Benjamin Franklin's system. Okay, how do we do it? We take a piece of paper, we divide it to two sides, one of which you write disadvantages, okay, or as you see, minus, and another one you write advantages. And you handle this piece of paper to your partners, clients, okay, and you ask them to write down the disadvantages they see. Or you just can ask them to name those disadvantages and you write down for them. Okay, once they did it, you take the opposite side of advantages and you start filling advantages. So if you are well prepared for this Benjamin Franklin's strategy, you would have this and however long is the list of disadvantages, you fill 2-3 times longer list on advantage side. Okay, so once you finish, this should be a good visual criteria for your clients helping to make a positive decision. Okay, they must see, okay, as everything in life it might have some disadvantages, okay, but the list of advantages is much greater, which supposes it's worth doing it. We do comparison of investments with other options. So you can compare investments in our project with other companies, products, and opportunities. Specify the risks of investing in bonds, securities, cryptocurrencies. Pay attention to the current situation in stock market. In the bold situation, highlight once again the advantages of investing in our project. This is a good strategy for some people, okay, but do not overcomplicate it, because as we say in duplication system, what you do, every single one must be able to do. So you might have some comparison, but do not go too deep into analytics, because someone else would feel they cannot repeat it, okay? And in duplication, we try to do only things that can be completed by others. Be respective to the clients, be inspired and overwhelmed with positive emotions. Address your client's name and remember, a salesman minus enthusiasm is just another clerk. Okay, that is the famous saying of Harry Banks. Sales technology is the best transport for business. But you can own the best car in the history of structural sales. But until you can drive this car, you will not move anywhere. So learn to make your trip more efficient and more effective. You must become a master and a professional driver, and people will believe you and will want to work together with you. So this is important, okay? All the way we learn. Successful follow-up strategy, following up. Money will start streaming towards you when your client's trust in you starts growing up. So do your best to become a reliable business partner for your clients. Always tell them the truth. When you can't answer the client's question, which is normal, don't make it up. Just tell the client that you haven't faced this question yet and that you will come with the answer in some time. So what distinguishes a successful seller from a failed seller is following up clients and supporting clients and taking care of clients. So those are very important steps, what you will do after you leave your clients, okay? This is not the last time you meet them. It should be not the last time you meet them. Right, communicating with the client. Always keep your communication channel open. Ask your client's permission to communicate with them after the first commercial meeting. Arrange the next meeting with the client, then send the client useful information and advice based on their needs and interests. Okay, you can send it by email, you can text or send, for example, by Messenger. Focus on high quality materials such as guides, articles, or training webinars. This is the most important steps in building trust between you and your new clients. Always do what you promised the clients and ask the clients to do what you agreed on with them. Okay, so this should be both ways good quality relationship. Referral contacts from a client. Ask the client to contact you with people in their field and ask how you can help their clients, okay? So the referral means you should always be able to get more contacts out of your clients, even though your clients will not do business with you. Okay, so if you are nice person, if you give value, your clients will link you to someone they think needs what you have in your proposals. So this is very, very important. And once you come to those people, once you meet a third party which is known by a new person you come to, you come with the extra built trust. Okay, so re-linking or recommendation that brings you more contacts, it's very good for you. And once you go there, you come there with the bigger reliability, okay, with the bigger credit of the person that sent you to his friends. Follow-up strategy. Not all people in network marketing pay enough attention to follow-up strategy, and this is the key to success in this business. Your solid strategy and follow-up tactics will differentiate you from other sales or builders of structures, as we call them. Okay, once you do good follow-up, you will be one or much more levels up than all other salesmen. So you will see how fast you start succeeding in this industry. And let's look at follow-up statistics. The below statistics show how successful you will be following up your clients. So if you follow up a client within 24 hours after the meeting, the chance that the client will register or make an investment is 70%. 70% is a fairly good rate, okay? If you contact a client in 2 to 4 days, your chance will be only 24%. So you lost almost 3 times by spending extra 2-3 days. And if you follow up within 5 to 10 days, your chance of success drops down to 7%. So why get 7% when you can get 70%? Don't let your clients cool down and be fast in following up. Clients' objections and argumentations. Steps for professional handling objections. So first is rapport, or highest describe personal experience. Tell your story. How did you feel yourself when you first heard about this project? Okay, this is a honesty exchange in honest story. And yeah, stories will do a lot of good if you will learn how to use them. The second one is analyze. Let's be specific. What did the client mean? How did the client understand you? So you must listen very, very well to what client says, and you must make sure you understand it in the right way. Okay, so you can double ask, double check, but make sure you really know client's needs. And you can test this by repeated questions, and after you test understanding with the closed questions. You do clarification and this finding options to make sure all the information you got it right. Right. What are most common objections in our business? I have no money. I don't have time. The market is full. I don't know many people. It's a pyramid. I don't have good experience with network marketing. It's not going to work. My husband or my wife will be against that. People won't believe me. I need some time to think. I'm not good enough for this job. I need certainty. The rule you must know about handling objections, that you do not agree with it. Show that you hear and you understand the point that was raised. You can say, yes, I fully understand that point you raised, and you repeat what was said. You know, I feel or I felt it the same way, or I know some people that thought about it same way as you just described. And you transition to story that would help you a lot by saying, let me tell you what I or what someone else found about it. Okay, and you put here the story. Now you can show the other side of how it helped someone, how people found others' side about getting more information, how they succeeded while being in the same situation. Network business is a business that does not require some very difficult skills. It requires not long time to learn this business and to start earning very good money. This industry provided many times to be best for millions of people in the world, with different ages, different education, different background, and living in any spot in the world, in any country of the world. So best way to know how people get the most in this industry is by listening to stories and later retelling it to others. Okay, this is very, very important part in networking, because people follow people. People do not do what you tell, people do what you do. People do not take it like from the advertisement, as it said, but they attempt to follow others as they hear stories and they relate those stories to themselves. Do not be afraid of objections. Behind each objection, there is client's interest in business. Give the clients a logical explanation for their objections and convince them that if they do what you have agreed on, they will be able to succeed, and you will help them to do that. So next time we will learn. Okay, next time we will learn more of duplication skills, and you can send questions, write what information you need to build big and strong team. We are here to help you, to support you, and to help your business grow. So the best you can do to yourself, bring all of your team to next training. Strong team is the key to your business success, and start practicing, as practice and more practice is what will bring you to success. No rejection shall stop you. Remember, 1,000 rejections will bring you to the very top in networking industry. So when you win, the world wins. Thank you for attending today's training.